Hi everybody, this is Kevin, and welcome back to another video. And today, I would like to share my thoughts on Discotech's recent announcement about Digimon, and how not only is Digimon Adventure 02 getting a Blu-ray release, but for the first time ever, we are getting the official release of Digimon the Movies. Now you might be asking, what do you mean by movies? Well, technically there are four movies in this soon-to-be Blu-ray, and they consist of Digimon the Movie from 2000, which we all know and love, but what you might not be aware of is the fact that that movie was originally comprised of three individual OVAs, and those three OVAs are Digimon Adventure, Our War Game, and get ready for this, Hurricane Touchdown Transcendent Evolution, The Golden Digimentals. I know, what a convoluted title, but that's what it's called. And while the first two OVAs, Adventure and Our War Game, were largely kept intact, they had to trim down Hurricane Touchdown, which was originally around 65 minutes. They cut more than half of it out. I think it was only around 30 minutes in the actual movie they put together almost 25 years ago, because they had to fit the runtime for an hour and 20 minutes or whatever it was back then. So they completely omitted the original cast. You know, the plot in general didn't really make a whole lot of sense, especially toward the end during the final battle against the Antilamon and then Cherubimon. So they're bringing back all the OVAs, unedited, uncut, uncensored, and with the original English dub. There's also a Japanese dub with subtitles if you're interested in that, but most of us fans are interested in the original dub. And all of the voice actors who could return did return. Sadly, a few of them passed away in recent years, and some of them are no longer in the voice acting industry. So there were recasts, but, you know, Joshua Seth returns, Mona Marshall, Brian Donovan, and even Matthew Reese, the original voice actor for Matt, who didn't reprise his role in Digimon Adventure Tri, but does reprise his role in these movies, which is just fantastic. So we're going to take a look at all these announcements from Discotech on their Twitter, take a look at the castings, and a whole lot more. I'll have all these things linked down below, because there are a few trailers. I'm not going to play the trailers in this video for fear of copyright, but you know, check them out. Check out the links in the description. You can hear Joshua Seth, you know, speaking in one of the trailers, and it's new lines, so you just gotta listen to it. It's fantastic, man. The fact that he's coming back to voice Ty, I love it. So the first thing we're going to talk about is Digimon, well, Season 2, Adventure 02. Discotech says, a familiar and well-loved theme song, more Digimon with Digimon Season 2, and there's a minute trailer here with the cast. Digimon Season 2, English masters were broke or missing, so we used the best Japanese footage we could get, found or recreated English tweaks, and rebuilt it. Then Astro Res upscaled it like Season 1. Japanese version will come later, and then English extra galleries, Japanese extras to be determined. Which, that's the thing. I have the first season, Digimon Adventure, on Blu-ray. They released this last December around Christmas time. And then a few months later, they released a completely different Blu-ray, which is just the Japanese version. Because with the English version, they did censor some things, like, you know, Matt and Ty are punching each other, and they edit out the punches. There's some demonic Digimon, like Myotismon and all of them. They'll have, like, devil imagery, pentagrams, things like that. And then, of course, Angewomon's cleavage. I had to censor that, so what they did with this Blu-ray is they used the Japanese footage, but then just overlaid the English voice acting, because for whatever reason, the English masters are all lost. They don't exist anymore. And there were DVD releases of these years and years ago, but you can see watermarks on them. There's like Fox Kids and TVYA watermarks on certain episodes. So, like, what the hell, man? This is the proper release. How many years later, we're finally getting the proper release? And the fact that Season 2, Adventure 02 is coming out, I have no doubt we're going to get Tamers, Frontier, Cross Wars, all of them will be released sooner or later, right? So there's some more stuff right here. Also, we know a few recaps and bits were missing. These are restored for the new release, such as the catch-up of the main characters at the beginning of Season 1. Mark FBR went over every this is missing. This was changed in repeats later, etc., to make sure they're there. And then here's some comparisons to the original version or DVD version to what it's like now. So you can see on the left it's more pixelated, it's sharper here on the right. Same thing here, like look how crappy that looks on the left there, and it's now been restored. and just a few examples, so that's nice. And then the main event right here, Otacon, Digimon, they actually screened this movie when they had this event last weekend. So what exactly are they talking about at that screening event? Let's get right into it for the trailer. Digimon the movies. I'll have this link below. You gotta watch this, man. It's so good. It gave me goosebumps watching it, man. And Digimon the movies is the original Digimon Adventure movie, OVA, Our War Game, Hurricane Touchdown, and Digimon the movie. So if you want the classic Digimon nostalgia, with, I hope, the original soundtrack with Smash Mouth and Less Than Jake and the Mighty Mighty Boss Toads. You know the classic soundtrack. Hopefully that's all included there. It says the original versions of the films with new uncut dubs with the classic cast. So yeah, like I said, this movie is around an hour and 20 minutes. They cut up, well, Adventure and Our War Game are largely intact, but they cut half of Hurricane Touchdown out, and now all three of the OVAs will be feature length with the English dub, for the first time ever, English dub. The new Digimon dubs have the cast you love, some of whom haven't been to the digital world in a while. Joshua Seth, Mona Marshall, Laura Jill Miller, the real Reese, that's Matthew Reese, who reprised his role as Matt years and years later. He didn't reprise his role as Matt in Digimon Adventure. Brian Donovan as Davis. The dub was directed and written by Marissa Lenti, script supervision by Mark FBR. Anyone who we could find and could come back is here. When needed, new actors were cast based on energy and giving a voice and vibe that fits you heard almost 25 years ago. So here's some of the voice actors talking about, you know, who they're voicing here. There's Derek Stephen Prince. And movie collection number one. Right? So over here, here's more of the cast. We'll look in the whole casting in a second, but here's some names like, you know, we got Doug Erhaltz, Paul St. Peter, Wendy Lay. All the voices you know and love, and some new casts like Shirami Lee and Wayne Grayson. So I thought this was really nice. This is from Bryce Papenbrook, which his father, Bob Papenbrook, voiced Red Greymon in the original movie years and years ago. And his father was a really talented voice actor all throughout the 90s and early 2000s until he passed away. And of course, you may know his son, Bryce, who's been in a lot of famous roles over the years, such as Eren Yeager in Attack on Titan, Kirito in Sword Art Online, Caesar in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, you name it. He's been in a ton of roles, and he wrote this nice tweet here. When I lost my dad 17 years ago, I decided to dedicate my life to voice acting in his honor, to carry on the torch for him, voicing Red Greymon in the new dub of the Digimon Adventure movie. Is the literal manifestation of that goal. We used my dad's voice as the vocal reference, and I did my best to honor his original performance. Thank you, Marissa and Discotech Media, for the opportunity and thoughtful casting. It means so much to me. Like, what a great story that is, man. The fact that Bryce Papenbrook, Bob Papenbrook's son, is voicing the same character his father voiced all those years ago. I mean, I just think it's terrific. So, good for him. I'm so happy he got to voice Red Greymon in that role. And wow, what a story, man. I love it. So over here, here's some more castings for the individual movies. Take a look at them. There's also, I should mention this, so like I said, a few of them did pass away in recent years, and they have a loving memory of them. We have Bob Papenbrook, Phyllis Sampler, Michael Lindsay, Joseph Pilato, Mike Reynolds, and Robert Axelrod. Bob Papenbrook voiced Red Greymon in the first OVA. Phyllis Sampler voiced Mimi. Michael Lindsay voiced Joe. Joseph Pilato voiced Metal Greymon. Mike Reynolds voiced Jedi. And Robert Axelrod voiced Armadillomon. And the original dub, he voiced Wizardmon. So rest in peace to all of them. Very nice that they added that too. So let's take a look at more of the castings. This is the 20-minute OVA. And you have all the original voice actors for the most part returning. Joshua Seth, Laura Jill Miller, Mona Marshall, Michael Reese, Wendy Lee, Colleen O'Shaughnessy, and you can go on down the line there. And Bob Buckles, I'm pretty sure Bob Buckles voiced Gene Starwood in Outlaw Star, doesn't he? So, there you go. So that's right there. Then we have our war game, which is 40 minutes. And again, all the original voice actors for the most part returning. They got Bradley Gareth to replace Joseph Pilato, Elsie Lovelock to replace Phyllis Sampler, Eli Farmer for Michael Lindsay, and then who voiced Jedi? Jason Mardocha. So yeah, you got that. And then in particular, we have Hurricane Touchdown Transcendent Evolution. I love that they have two explanation marks as well. The Golden Digimentals, 65 minutes. Like I said, in the original movie, they trimmed it down to like 30 minutes. They really edited the hell out of it, and they omitted all the original Digidestined. But they got Bob Gluberman to reprise his role as Willis, who hasn't done any anime in years. And he's come back to voice Willis, so good for that. Again, they got all these other people. And I didn't even realize that Lopmon had a speaking role in this movie. I don't think Lopmon was in the original Digimon movie. Maybe it was in the OVA. And I guess has a speaking role. And the fact that Lopmon is voiced by Shirami Lee, one of my favorite voice actors, who of course voices Lucy Harpilia in Fairy Tail, among many other roles. And I just know she's going to do a great job as Lopmon. So I can't wait to see that scene and hear her performance. And then Wayne Grayson here is replacing Robert Axelrod, who passed away for Armadillomon. And if you don't know, Wayne Grayson voiced Joey Wheeler in Yu-Gi-Oh!, among other roles. So I think they did a phenomenal job with the cast list, you know, getting pretty much everyone to return, and the people who did pass away getting really solid replacements. And I'm really looking forward to watching these movies. There's no release date quite yet for them. If I had to guess, because this movie came out last Christmas around that time, I would guess Adventure Zero 2 is going to come out around the same time, and then perhaps the movies will come out shortly after. And I'm really looking forward to it. And Discotech, man, I have quite a few. Let me show you the other Discotech Blu-rays I have. I have this one, Gunbuster, the OVA series, which I got recently. There's also Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo, which I don't think... This is sort of the same deal as Digimon, which someone will have to leave a comment. How does Discotech get the rights to these things? Because as far as I'm concerned, isn't Toei and Bandai Namco in charge of this? And same thing, like, there's no proper release for the Blu-ray, so you would think Bandai Namco or Toei would do a Blu-ray release, but then Discotech has to swoop in and release it, and how do they release Bobobo? Like, I don't really get how that works, but okay. Star Ocean EX, this is Star Ocean the Second Story adapted into an anime, and then Tales of Symphonia, same thing, like, you'd think Bandai Namco owns this, but apparently not. Apparently Discotech has to do it. So, one more thing I wanted to talk about as well before moving on is we finally got the announcement of a Blu-ray release of Evangelion 3.0 plus 1.0 Thrice Upon a Time, which now they're calling it 3.0 plus 1.11 Thrice Upon a Time, which what the fuck is that about? And it's surprising that it's getting a Blu-ray release because Amazon owns the rights to it. But G-Kids is able to publish physical media, so it's not bad. It's $30. But I'm just reading this, and I'm like, what does this even mean? Bonus features, is that 46 hours? Like, what is that? 3.0, 46 hours, and then 3.0, 120 minutes? Is that the three movie? Like, what? So they have this basic edition for $30, and then they have the collector's edition for $80, which... What do they have in the collectors? They have a booklet and art cards. So the art cards looks like you got Mari, Karu, Asuka, Rei, Misato, and Shinji. And then if you go to Right Stuff, they're cheaper. 24 and 72. So, yeah, I've reviewed all the Evangelion series and movies on the channel. The original series, Death True, End of Evangelion. And then the rebuild movies, which, yeah, I own the rebuild movies. 1.11, You Are Not Alone. 2.22, You Cannot Advance, but the best girl, Mari. and then 3.33 you cannot redo. So the thing with these movies is Funimation with them out. Funimation no longer owns the rights because Amazon swooped in and got the rights, and they recast everybody, which these dubs were fucking great. The only ones I think returned were the originals, like Spike Spencer and all them from the original 90s dub, and then John Swayze, but everyone else they recast, which I don't know, man. The dub of these is fucking keto. So anyway. So another thing about Discotheque too I should mention is, you know, I'm just looking at more of their catalog and I saw this. Let me show you this real quick. Again, how does Discotheque get the rights to these things? But I saw this Fist of the North Star movie, right? Which originally came out in 2006 and then got released in 2023, February 2023. And I'm looking at it and this is the first one, right? That got re-released, and there's three more. And I'm looking at the dubbing. Look at this cast, man. You got Jason Douglas, Robbie Damon, David Wald, Christopher Sabat. Like, look at this. Linda Young's in it. What a legend. I don't know, man. I gotta check this out. Like, how do they get the rights to publish these things? Like, good for Discotheque. It's awesome. But, yeah. I don't know. So, what do you guys think? I am so excited for the release of the Digimon movies. I can't wait to watch them again. I'm getting them date. As soon as I get the release date and I'm able to pre-order it, I'm pre-ordering it. I can't wait. I still haven't watched. Like, I bought this last year. I still haven't watched it. Like, I put it in just to see, like, how nice it looks. And it looks so good. The fact that they upscaled everything in HD and all that looks beautiful, but I still haven't like sat down and watched it because I've been kind of burnt out after watching Ghost Game last year. And let me just say that too, how is it that Toei and Bandai Namco are mishandling Digimon so badly? Like, Ghost Game was pretty mediocre. It was okay, you know, we're not gonna be too harsh on it. It was just okay. Now they're doing this goofy web novel series where you have Discotheque getting the rights like, how come Bandai or Toei doesn't release this? Why does Discotheque have to go and release it? Like, I don't get how that works, man. Like how is an American company treating this franchise better than the actual IP owners? Like, that's just goofy to me. And the video games, man. Digimon Survive, which are not, again, okay. The game was okay. Like, where's the next Digimon World game or whatever? And you're doing this stupid Digimon visual novel, Digimon Seekers? I was looking, like, when they first announced it, all the Digimon YouTubers were, like, trying to cover it, and no one's watching it. No one cares about those videos, man. So I don't know what Digimon's doing. Where's the next anime? I guess they're doing the 02 movie, The Beginning, which that's coming out in October. I think October 27th or something. Yeah, they just got a new announcement. There's a new trailer for that, too. So that's cool. But anyway, what do you guys think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and stay tuned for more videos coming soon. Peace out. 99.